define kernel of a homomorphism. The meaning of kernel is the central or most important part of something. But here, kernel of a homomorphism, we mean it is the most important part of homomorphism. If F is a homomorphism of a group G into a group G dash, then the kernel of F is a set of all elements in G which are mapped into the identity element of G dash. In symbol, the kernel of F is KER, that stands for the short form of kernel. Kernel of F is equals to the set A belongs to G such that F of A equals to E dash. That is, we have to write all the elements of G which are mapped onto the element E dash, where E dash is the identity element of the codomain group, where E dash is the identity of G dash. This is a group G. This is a group G dash. Now F is a function. Consider the group G having elements A, B, C, E, X, Y, Z, so on. And here also we have elements of G dash B, A dash, B dash, E dash, C dash, X dash, so on. And assume that E dash is the identity element of G dash. Now, assume that the image of A is E dash, that is F of A equal to E dash, and F of C equal to E dash, F of E equal to E dash, F of E must be always equal to E dash, because in homomorphism, the identity element of the domain group must always map on to the identity element of the codomain group. Therefore, F of E must be equal to E dash. And now, what is kernel of this function? Here, the kernel of this function F is from G to G dash is, what is the definition of kernel F? Set of all elements of G which are mapped into E dash. G has many elements A, B, C, E, X, Y, Z, so on. But which are the elements mapped into the identity element of G dash, namely E dash? The elements are A, C and E. And these three elements are known as kernel of F. Therefore, kernel of F is equals to A, C and E. This is how we have to find kernel of a given function or kernel of a homomorphism. Note, if E is the identity of G, then F of E must be equal to E dash. That is, E belongs to kernel of F. That is, at least one element exists in kernel of F. Therefore, kernel of F is non-empty. F of X is equal to E dash if and only if X belongs to kernel of F. That is, F of any element of the domain group G is equals to the identity element E dash of the codomain group G dash, then the element X must be in kernel of F. Or if any element X belongs to kernel of F, then it must satisfy the condition, namely F of X is equals to E dash. Therefore, this is very important when we discuss problems or theorems. Examples: if G is a group of non-zero real numbers under multiplication, prove that F is from G to G dash such that F of X is equal to X squared is a homomorphism for all X belong to G. Also find the kernel of the function F. Here G is non-zero real numbers, that is R minus singleton set 0, that is set of real numbers except the element 0, that is known as non-zero real numbers. Here the operation is multiplication. Therefore, clearly the identity in G is 1. Let A comma B belong to G, then A into B belongs to G by closure axiom. Since A belongs to G, by definition of F, F of A is equal to X squared. Similarly, B belongs to G, by definition of F, F of B equals to B squared. Now let us consider F of A into B. To prove that F is a homomorphism, we have to show that F of A into B is equal to F of A into F of B. Since A into B is a single element which belongs to G, by definition of F, F of A into B is equal to A into B whole square. Therefore, F of A into B equal to AB whole square. Now, by law of indices, it can be written as A squared into B squared. What is A squared? A squared is equal to F of A. What is B squared? By definition of the function F, B squared equal to F of B. Therefore, that is equal to F of A into F of B. Therefore, F is a homomorphism from G into G, where G is a group of non-zero real numbers under multiplication. Now we have to determine kernel F. That is, you have to find the value of kernel of the function F. We know that definition of kernel F says set of all elements X belong to G such that F of X is equal to E dash, where E dash is the identity element in the codomain group. Here the codomain group is also G, that is G is a non-zero real numbers, and since G is a group of non-zero real numbers under multiplication, the identity is 1. Therefore, F of X is equals to 1. But F of X is equals to X squared. That is, F of X value is 1. Therefore, 1 is equal to X squared. That is, X squared is equal to 1, which is a quadratic equation. And hence, X has two values, namely plus or minus 1. Plus is a positive real number. Minus 1 is a negative real number. And hence, the kernel of F will have set of all elements of G which are mapped into 1. What are the elements? Now the elements are nothing but plus 1 and minus 1. Therefore, kernel of the function F is equals to 1 and minus 1. Thus, the 1 and minus 1 are the kernel of the function F, which is a homomorphism from G to G, where G is a group of non-zero real numbers under multiplication. Z comma plus is a group of integers, and F is from Z to Z defined by F of X is equal to 3X for all X belong to Z. It's a homomorphism. Find the kernel of F. Solution. Since Z is a group of integers with respect to addition, clearly 0 is the identity element of the group Z. By definition, kernel of F is defined as set of all elements of the domain group Z which are mapped into the identity element of the codomain group, namely Z. That is, F of X is equals to 0. Now we have to consider this part. We are going to get the value of kernel F using F of X is equals to 0. So F of X is equal to 0. What is F of X? F of X is defined as 3 into X. Therefore, next step we have to write 3 into X is equal to 0. That is, when you say 3 into X is equal to 0, either 3 equal to 0 or X is equal to 0. but 3 cannot be 0, and hence the only possibility is x is equal to 0. That is, the only element which is mapped into the identity element of the codomain group is 0. That is, only 0 is mapped into the 0 of codomain group, and hence kernel of F is nothing but 0, and the 0 is nothing but the identity element of the group Z. Define a function F is from G to G by F of x is equal to 2 to the power x for all x belong to G. Find the kernel of F. G is a group under multiplication. Clearly, 1 is the identity element because G is a group under multiplication. The definition of kernel of F says ker F is equals to set of all elements of G which are mapped into the identity element of the codomain group G. Here the identity element is 1, therefore F of x is equals to 1. To get the value of kernel of F, we have to consider F of x is equals to 1. Therefore, F of x is equal to 1. What is F of x? F of x is defined as 2 to the power x. Therefore, it is 2 to the power x equals to 1. And we know that 2 to the power 0 is 1. And hence, the value of x will be 0. Thus, x is equal to 0. And hence, kernel of F is equal to 0. That is, 0 of the domain group G is mapped into the identity element 1 of the codomain group G. Remember that both G are one and the same. But here the 0 is mapped into the identity element 1 of the group. Therefore, kernel of F is 0. We shall now prove a theorem. If F is a homomorphism of a group G into a group G dash, then the kernel of F is a normal subgroup of G. We are given F is a homomorphism from G to G dash. We have to show that kernel of F is a normal subgroup of G. So it consists of two parts. First, we will show that kernel of F is a subgroup of G. Then we have to show that kernel of F is normal, and hence you can conclude that kernel of F is a normal subgroup of G. Proof: let F from G to G dash be a homomorphism. It is an into homomorphism. That is, F is a function from G to G dash satisfying the condition F of A into B is equals to F of A into F of B. That is, F of A into B is equal to F of A into F of B for all A comma B belong to G. Let K be the kernel of F. We have to show that kernel of F, namely K, is a normal subgroup of G. By definition of kernel of F, K is equal to set of all elements of G such that F of A equal to E dash, where E dash is the identity element of the group G dash. So this is a group G, domain group. This is a codomain group G dash, and there is a function F from G to G dash. Now we have elements A, B, C, E, D, so on. Here we consider the elements of G dash B, A dash, B dash, C dash, E dash, X dash, Y dash, so on. Now we have to find which are the elements of G which are mapped into the identity element E dashed of the group G dash. And those elements which are mapped into E dash will form a normal subgroup of G. That is, for example, A is mapped into E dash, C is mapped into E dash, and E is mapped into E dash. and assume that this kernel of F will have elements A, C, E. Now we have to show that the set containing elements A, C, E will form a normal subgroup of G. That is the procedure. Now, since F of E equals to E dash, this implies E belongs to K. The identity element of the group G must map into the identity element of the codomain group G dash. That is, F of E must be equal to E dash. That implies, by definition of kernel, this E must belong to K. What is K? K is the kernel of F. That is, at least one element will be there in the set K. Therefore, K is non-empty. And K is a subset of G, because the elements of K are from G only. From G. Therefore, K is a subset of G, and hence K is a non-empty subset of G. Let A comma B belong to K. By definition of the kernel of F, we know that F of A equals to E dash and F of B is equals to E dash. Now we have to show that K is a subgroup of G. This theorem consists of two parts. The first part is K is subgroup of G, then we'll show that K is normal in G, and hence we can conclude that K is a normal subgroup of G. Let us prove the first part, namely K is a subgroup of G. For this, we shall recall a theorem which are proved in the topic subgroup. H is a non-empty complex of G. The necessary and sufficient condition for H to be a subgroup of G is A comma B belong to H implies AB inverse belongs to H, where B inverse is the inverse of B in G. Using this statement, we are going to show that K is a subgroup of G. For this, we have to choose two elements A and B from K. Then we have to show that this AB inverse also belongs to K. So A comma B belongs to K. This implies F of A equals to E dash and F of B equal to E dash by definition of kernel. This is the definition of kernel. That is, F of X is equal to E dash if and only if X belongs to kernel of F or K here. We have to show that AB inverse belongs to K. To show that AB inverse belongs to K, when do you say X belongs to kernel of F? We say that X belongs to kernel of F or X belongs to K only if F of X is equals to E dash. Therefore, to prove that AB inverse belongs to K, we have to show that F of AB inverse is equals to E dash. F of AB inverse equals to E dash. Let us consider F of AB inverse. F of AB inverse equals to F of A into F of B inverse, because F is a homomorphism. That is equal to F of A into F of B whole inverse. This is one of the properties of homomorphism, namely F of B inverse is equals to F of B whole inverse. F of A is E dash. F of B is also E dash. Therefore, we have started with A comma B belong to K. Now we have proved that AB inverse belongs to K. Hence, by this theorem, K is a subgroup of the group G. Now we have to show that K is normal in G. We shall now prove that K is normal. Let us recall the definition of normal. A subgroup H of a group G is called a normal subgroup of G if for every X belongs to G, and for every H belongs to H, X, H, X inverse belongs to H. Here, just now we have proved K is a subgroup of the group G. So, to show that this K is normal, we have to choose one element X from G and one element A from K, and we have to show that X, A, X inverse belongs to K. Let X belong to G and A belong to K. Since A belongs to K, by definition of kernel, we have F of A equals to E dash. Now we have to show that K is normal. For that we have to show that X, A into X inverse belongs to K. To prove X into A into X inverse belongs to K, again by definition of kernel, we know that some element X belongs to K if and only if F of X is equals to E dash. To show that X, A, X inverse belongs to K, now we have to show that F of X, A, X inverse equals to E dash. Therefore, we have to consider F of X, A, X inverse. So, let us consider F of X into A into X inverse. What is F? F is a homomorphism. What's a homomorphism? F of A into B equal to F of A into F of B. And this can be extended to any number of elements in G. Therefore, F of X, A, X inverse is equals to F of X into F of A into F of X inverse. That is equals to F of X into F of A. And we know that F of X inverse is equals to F of X the whole inverse. What is the value of F of A? F of A value is E dash. Therefore, F of X into E dash into F of X whole inverse. If you multiply any element with identity, we get the same element. Therefore, equals to F of X into F of X inverse. And this is of the form A into A inverse. What is A into A inverse? A into A inverse is equals to the identity. Here A is equal to F of X. Therefore, F of X into F of X inverse equals to E dash. Thus, F of X into A into X inverse equals to E dash. Therefore, we say that X, A, X inverse belongs to K. That means K is normal in G. Just now we have proved K is a subgroup of G. Now we have shown that K is normal in G, and hence K, the kernel of F, is a normal subgroup of G.